Hi, welcome back to the MIGRO YouTube channel. We've got an update today on the soil versus hydro test. And we got some good news and some bad news. The bad news really is on this side, on the hydro side. Given my inexperience and ineptitude possibly at the hydro stuff, we've had a few problems. And although the growth rate has been good, the quality of the growth has not been that very good. So let's just look at what I have been doing, and then I'll make my best stab at what mistakes I've made, and then you can tell me what your opinion is. But yeah, let's look at it first. So we come down here, we'll have a look. I've been doing my sort of twice weekly checks on various things. So pH, the concentration of nutrients, so looking at the parts per million of nutrients in the solution, and then just looking at the system overall to make sure it's functioning, and particularly air, because I've had problems with the air pebbles blocking up. So just do a quick demonstration here of what I've been checking. So we've been testing the pH. We've got our blue pH pen still in calibration, also gives me the temperature reading, and the reading at the moment is 6.2 and 20 degrees Celsius. It was calibrated to, I put a feed in on Monday, after which the pH generally rises quite high, and I changed it. I adjusted it down, and it's gone back up, drifted up back up a little bit, so I need to put in some pH down to adjust that. And I got the Blue Lab plan for the Blue Lab truncheon nutrimeter for testing ppm, and this is running at 600 there at the moment, so that's fine if we want it. And then we have temperature and humidity. So 54% humidity, and the temperature has been running between minimum of 12 at night and maximum of 29. So we're staying within our control parameters on the environment. So yeah, the other inspection you've got to do, it's a little bit tight in here, but we'll try to get a decent view on it, is just to have a look at what the pot is doing underneath. Make sure that everything is still bubbling. You can see the root mass there has built up quite a heavy, thick, dense root mass. So despite keeping the pH within a reasonable band and adjusting it, as I said, every 2 or 3 days, at least inspecting it every 2 or 3 days, water temperature being in range, nutrient levels being where they should be, light levels being okay, at least the same as the soil side, we've definitely had some nutrient deficiency. The collapse, we've had a collapse of a plant in the back here. Basically, the large internodal distance was, that's the same on both sides, but they're very, very delicate stems which have been snapping, and the plants have been falling over. They just haven't been strong and rigid to hold up themselves. So I know there's nutrient deficiency there. There's a little bit on the leaves too, which of course is my fault. I need to be identifying that and correcting it in terms of the mix. But yeah, it's quite frustrating that you buy high quality nutrients and they don't do the job. Basically, you have to add more stuff to them so that they're complete. The other aspect really is that although we've had really good growth, there's much less flowers over here, and I haven't found a single fruit over on this side yet. Which is again, it's behind the soil side in that sense. Other than me making a complete disaster of it, it's been fine. It's been absolutely fine. But anyway, yeah. So I haven't covered myself in glory. We might have to do this one again, taking on board the constructive criticism. I'm sure I'll get through the comments. Oh yeah, not going so well. Bit of a disaster. However, soil side is saving the day. On the soil side, things have been wonderfully simple. Unlike the RDWC side, this has required very little attention. I've got a freshwater reservoir with drip feed it's on for a few cycles, comes on for 5 minutes, three or four times a day to feed the plants. Top up the reservoir about once a week. Simple as. In terms of feed, been using Canna Terra Bio and feeding that on the Flora one and then on the Bloom one, and feeding just once a week. Hasn't really been any sign of nutrient deficiency. The growth is about the same as the RDWC side, as the hydro side, but the plant development is much, much better. So lots and lots of flowers on here, much stronger stems, plants have been holding themselves up perfectly, and even got quite a lot of fruit going already. No fruit on the RDWC side, lots of fruit over here. So let's go down and just take a little closer look at the plants. So you can see in the development really here with the on the soil side, we've got strong stems. I can give them a shake, things don't fall off. They're all standing up on their own, quite tight development, relatively strong nodes. Nothing has snapped off on this side. And we got some large fruit, so I'm going to give the first taste test here. So I will pick one out of here. They're definitely going to be too young, but it will be interesting to see what they're like. So
yeah, let's see.
Definitely tastes like a pepper. Not a huge amount of flavor, more than green flavor. Not chili yet, but they're young, so we'll give them a chance. We'll try them next time. That's it for now. Take care.